Hello, I'm Berrien Moore, Dean of the College of Atmospheric and Geographic Sciences, Director of the National Weather Center, and Vice President for Weather and Climate Programs here at OU. One of the important topics that we're going to be treating in this class is the study of the global carbon cycle, how that cycle works naturally, and how it has been perturbed by human activities. It's going to be a fun adventure. Of course, it's a fundamental interest. What will be the carbon dioxide concentration over the next 10 years, over the next 20 years, over the next century? This involves a lot of uncertainty. First of all, what are humans going to do? What will be the energy system of the planet? How will we swap out the fossil fuel system, which is the primary energy system of the planet, and swap in a non-fossil system, something that doesn't add carbon dioxide to the atmosphere? That's a big problem. And we simply don't know how we're going to do that. The addition of carbon dioxide to the atmosphere has and will change the climate. Well, what will that do? It is, after all, a system. Climate system is connected to the carbon system. I mean, the most obvious thing is vegetation. Vegetation takes up carbon dioxide in photosynthesis and it gives it back when it respires. Well, that obviously is affected by weather and climate. But so is the ocean. In cold waters, CO2 is more soluble. In warm waters, CO2 is less soluble. Well, as you change the temperature of the planet, you're going to change the surface temperature of the ocean in different ways. What will that do? Another thing is, probably if you change the temperature of the planet, you're going to change the water cycle. Are you going to evaporate more water? Therefore, you have to rain more water. So if you change the water cycle, you know that that would lead to changes in vegetation, plant productivity, would even lead to the changes in the salinity of the ocean. Solubility is also influenced by salinity. So all of these things will change the carbon cycle. So human activity will change it, and then climate will change the carbon cycle, and carbon cycle will change the climate. It is a problematique. It is a problem of problems because it's a system of systems. So we're going to try to sort that out with what we know, what we think we know, and what we don't know.